And welcome back to Caitlyn's Destiny. Well, we just talked to old Artie and learned that we have to find a spellbook. But before we do that, let's have a look at the books. There are many books on the shelf. You do not recognize a single one and they seem magically related. Okay, we can have a look around without the around because the game doesn't know it. You are in Wizard Artie's home. It's quite cozy. The wizard sits in the chair reading a book. His dog Puck lays on the ground, wagging his tail. Alright, let's pet him. We do not go upstairs because there is a bug. If you're upstairs, the game says, well, you're not invited and you can never get out of there but without closing it and shutting it down, and then we don't want to do that, so we just pet the dog and did all we have to do. We can have a look at this table, but it won't let us, I guess, I believe. Yeah, exactly. So, let's go and find our neighbor, Florizel. Well, since he's our neighbor, he should live next door. And hey, what's that? Who's that? Let's have a look at the boy. That's Percy, and he's trying to get his ball from the tree. Can we talk to him? We're not close enough. Okay. Can we talk to him now? Just press the F3 button. It's exactly like in the old Sierra games, and yeah, we can talk to him. Hey, Percy, how are you today?
Not so good, Caitlyn. My ball is stuck in that tree. I was playing and threw it too high. What am I going to do?
Oh, well, that's a shame, Percy. I wish I could find a way to help you, but I have important things to take care of.
Oh, that's okay, Caitlyn. But hey, look at this neat statue I found. It looks like a snake.
Percy shows you the statue. It's a definite antique. It looks as though it may be worth something to a collector. Well, that's some interesting information. Maybe we can get the kid his ball back and get the statue in return. That's an adventure game. It's really nice, Percy. Mind if I have it?
No way, Caitlyn. Well, unless you get me my ball back, then yeah, well, I give it to you for sure.
Okay, I'll see what I can do.
Okay, I'm gonna keep on trying. Bye-bye.
Alright, can we climb the tree? We cannot even walk around this. Now we'll have to walk around the stone. Alright, and try to climb the tree. Climb, and climb. Oops, climb tree. I am sorry. The tree is too high to climb. Well, how nice. Okay. We cannot walk through there. So, let's go on to her. She doesn't walk over roots. She doesn't walk under trees. And so you will always have to try to direct her around it. So let's have a look at this scene. You're in the forest of Valeria. How nice. Okay, there's nothing else to see. And up there is the town, but whoo, we have now entered a much darker part of the forest. You know that if you were to continue west, you would be entering dark mist woods. A place of shadowy creatures with an affinity for human flesh. Ooh, it would be wise to consider not entering this part of the forest. Now, okay, go away. All right. I guess we'll have to go there later, but a bit later in the game, because first, of course, we'll have to get our spellbook. We still haven't seen all of this part of the town yet. But we will do so later on. Let's have a look at this fountain. This looks nice. Oops. Okay. The fountain is rumored to be magical. Although you've never understood why. Can we drink? The water tastes cool and fresh. But it doesn't do any magic to us. That's a shame, isn't it? Would be a lot easier. Okay, so if we live in the blue house, maybe we're lucky a neighbor Florizel lives right next door to us. You can also never access all the houses in the background, which is a shame, but they're just there for decoration and to fill the screen. Okay, let's open this door now. And who's that? Hello, Florizel. How are you today? Hey, we found Florizel. Wonderful.
Oh, Caitlyn, good to see you. I'm just fine today. What brings you here this morning?
I'm looking for something not of the ordinary.
Out of the ordinary? What could that be?
Well, believe it or not, the wizard Archie requires that I find a spellbook. I was hoping that maybe you knew of if my grandfather had one that he left behind.
So, Caitlyn, you're finally noticing the magic inside you. Cicero would always tell me that you would turn out to be a great user of magic. Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. Noticing? I haven't noticed anything. Everyone keeps telling me I have these powers. I can't say I totally believe them, but the king said he needs my help.
Don't you worry, Caitlyn. You should not believe what everyone tells you, but you should keep an open mind. Trust Artie. He will surely be true to his word.
Well, we definitely hope so, huh? Oh, boy. Thanks, Florizel. Now, what about the spellbook?
I'm afraid I never heard of such an item being left behind by Cicero. He did not have a lot of possessions, and many of them went to others when he died.
Oh, my goodness. I hope it's not the spellbook that went to others. Oh, great. Now, what am I supposed to do?
Don't worry, Caitlyn. I have something your grandfather did leave you.
Uh-huh. And why didn't you give it to me before? What did he leave me? Huh? What?
Yes, no, perhaps it will help you on your quest. Hold on a moment while I get it.
Okay. Thanks, Florizel. So we'll have to wait now until the old guy walks up. Hey, he's pretty fast. But I turned the speed to fast, so that's no problem. And there, oh, he already returns. We can't even look around. Our parser doesn't work now. And what?
Here you go, Caitlyn. Cicero has left me this note before he passed away. Yeah.
Thanks for your help, Florizel.
All right, thank you. Yeah.
You're welcome, Caitlyn. Good luck on your adventure.
Florizel hands you a dusty old note. You decide to read it later. Can we still talk to him? Talk? Man, thanks for all the help. No, okay.
Come by any time for a visit.
All right. Oh, I should look around a bit. You're in your neighbor's house. Florizel sits in a chair, enjoying some tea and the heat from the fire. But we can't do anything here. We can't take flour, or can we? No, we can't take anything else. We can't walk upstairs. Well, we can. There is no bug, but we don't get far. We don't get all the way upstairs. So our mission with Florizel is accomplished. And now let's go into our house and meet the next bug, because she will snail around here. Yeah. All right. Here we are at home. Nice place. First, let's go into this room. And look. I can do that here. I can do that here, yes. You're in your cozy home. Your grandfather left you this place when he died. You have been taking care of it since. All right. So, look. Table. The table has a few of empty jars on it. Yeah, but only in the room to the right, and we can't get them here. But what, of course, we should do is read this note. Then look note. This is a note Florizel gave you from your father. It reads, Caitlyn, if you are reading this now, you wish to develop your magic. You have great power within you, so use it wisely. I hid a spellbook in the house made especially for you. Seek it out and begin your journey. Good luck. Love, Cicero. Oh, well. Well, maybe, we have a lot of books here. You have quite a book collection in your home. Take book. No, you read all of them. Okay, and we don't read them now. We can't look at the shelf. I tried that. We can't walk through. I hope she's not stuck now. Oh, no. Ah, all right. Look, elf. Nope, doesn't understand it. But what we can do is get the rug, because surprise, surprise, you move the dusty rug and discover a trapdoor. Upon opening the trapdoor, you find an old book. Yay! Well, I suppose I should look inside. Yes, please do so, Caitlyn. Inside the cover it reads, "Dear Caitlyn, I made the spellbook for you when you were very young. Activate it and use it well. Let your magical birthright grow with your experiences. Cherish this gift and know that I will always love you. From Grandfather Cicero." You put away the spellbook, happy with a message from your grandfather. Perhaps this magic business is not so unbelievable after all. You replace the rug, and we take the book, I hope. Let's check our inventory. So here we have a spellbook, and we have the note. Great. And there is another bug. Anytime you press enter on the spellbook, it says your strength spell can allow you to pick up heavy objects and bend metal. But, of course, we don't have any strength spell yet, and we won't have it until a lot later in the game, so I guess this is just another bug we came across, which isn't half as bad as the one with the upstairs at Artie's house. Yeah, we still have time to walk into the next room. There is the door. And now here are the jars on the table, and here we can take a jar. Yeah, it took me a while to figure out that I had to walk to the next room, and now we carry a jar. We still do have time to walk upstairs. There is absolutely nothing now. Go upstairs. And she's snailing around the house. There is absolutely nothing to do in this room. Look. Your grandfather, yes, we had that. We can try to open this drawer. But we're not close enough. We cannot open this drawer. So we have to walk into our room, I guess, with a pink bed. And try to open the drawer here. And we can. We discover 2 gold coins. Yeah, great. And we remember to spend them wisely. Because we will not have any more money for a while. Why not? We could always go and make some. All right. If we try to read book. Look book. Spell book. Yeah, even if we say look spell book. It tells me the same. So, we can only read the book when we're outside. Where did we go down? That was here, yes. Okay, so that's all we could do in our nice little house. We'll never see it again, that much I can tell you. And I guess we should continue our quest in the next video. We still have to act it. Oh no, we can look spellbook here. It's the spellbook that grandfather made for us. You shouldn't have any problem casting spells now that you have it. Yeah, just we don't have any spells in there, except for the strength spell, which doesn't work. Well, okay, we'll continue our quest in the next video, so thanks for watching so far, and stay tuned.